FDA Center for Tobacco Products. Rulemaking 101. The Tobacco Control Act is a law that gives FDA the authority to oversee how tobacco products are made, marketed, sold, and distributed in the United States. Carrying out this law and writing and issuing new rules or regulations that implement the law are important ways that FDA's Center for Tobacco Products, or CTP, helps to protect people in the United States from disease and deaths caused by tobacco product use. A rule may be needed to address a public health concern, to update current rules, or if required by a new law, court order, or to adopt an administration policy. After a need is identified, CTP starts the rulemaking process with planning activities to gather information and discuss what to include in a proposed rule before then writing the proposed rule. The proposed rule is then reviewed within FDA. After that, other parts of the federal government, such as the Department of Health and Human Services, or HHS, and the Office of Management and Budget, or OMB, also review it. After all the reviews are completed, a proposed rule, also called a Notice of Proposed Rulemaking, or NPRM, is published in the Federal Register for public comment. Next is the public's turn. There are usually 60 to 90 days to submit public comments online at regulations.gov or by mail. Public comments may include data, research, or other information which point out parts of a proposed rule that may be confusing or suggest different wording. Comments are not votes. CTP reviews all public comments submitted before the deadline and then decides what further action is needed. Based on the comments, CTP may decide to end the rulemaking process, to issue a new proposed rule, or to issue a final rule. When preparing a final rule, CTP will provide a summary of the public comments on the proposed rule and the agency's responses. CTP also must explain what, if any, changes were made to the rule as a result of those comments. The final rule must be reviewed by others in FDA as well as HHS and OMB before it can be published. Some final rules take effect right away, but most provide a time period for companies or other affected groups to make the changes needed to follow the rule, such as updating a product's label or training employees. After the effective date of the rule, it has the same force and effect as a law. Companies or other affected groups that do not follow the final rule may then be fined or face other enforcement actions. To learn more, visit fda.gov/tobacco rulemaking.